His name was Comanche. He was a battle-trained horse, and an officer's mount was he. He carried the brave Captain Miles Keel of the 7th Cavalry. There was an uncommon bond between those two, as close as a soldier and a horse could ever be. From the desert southwest to the hills of Montana rode the captain and Comanche. When Custer assembled his troops on that morning, and the wife said goodbye to their men, with a chill in their hearts, somehow they knew they'd not see their husbands again. Little Bighorn would be their destiny, and the fight to the last dying man. When the bugler blew the charge, they never knew they'd play right in the crazy horse hand. Hillside lay still for 2 days until Bradley's troops did arrive. He found not a soul left, just a horse near his death, standing by the dead captain's side. What could this horse tell of this man-made hell? What has he seen through his own eyes? Though his life was fading, he seemed to be waiting for his poor captain to rise. When the Sioux and the Cheyenne spoke of this battle that's known as Custer's last stand, they tell of a soldier so brave in the saddle who died with the reins in his hand. All the men killed their mounts and used them for shields, but the captain couldn't shoot his best friend. So he stayed in the stirrups, and two gallant warriors fought together right to the end.
And the widows did weep for the men that all sleep in the battlefield right where they fell. There was no one alive, just Comanche survived. If he could talk, what would he tell? Would he tell how Crazy Horse circled his armies, rain in the face swooping down, and Custer's men falling like leaves in the wind, and the grass turning red on the ground?
Through all the smoke and the killing, this horse was still willing, till a bullet went right through his side. And when the captain went down, he fired from the ground, still holding the reins as he died.
They put that noble beast on a steamer headed east, for the sole survivor was he. In a gesture so grand, made him second in command of the 7th Cavalry.
He led every parade for that 7th Brigade for several years after the wars. Saddled and bridled and draped in mourning, he'd never carry a rider evermore.
And the widows did weep for the men that all sleep in the battlefield right where they fell. There was no one alive, just Comanche survived. If he could talk, what would he tell? And the widows did weep for the men that all sleep in the battlefield right where they fell. There was no one alive, just Comanche survived. If he could talk, what would he tell? And the widows did weep for the men that all sleep in the battlefield right where they fell.